It's time now for Storm Watch at the Weather Channel. We'll have a look at what's happening in the tropics and around our country. Let's begin a look, first of all, at our tropical update here. First of all, here's a map of great interest, including a couple of spots we're watching. Yeah, including not too far from the Pacific coast. We've got some couple of hurricanes we're looking at here. Also, right in this region here, we have an area of disturbed weather just being monitored. Also right here, another little wave receiving a bit of shear. Or is getting a bit of rip, kind of going over the top of it, working right now to preclude any type of development. Let's hope that continues. It is expected to do so as far as that continues to keep anything from popping here. Actually, climatologically speaking, right now is not the most likely time of the year for the Cape Verde region to be a source region for tropical activity. These systems right through here, yeah, number of spots we're dealing with as far as that goes on a little bit closer toward the U.S. coast. In other words, not off the Cape Verde region. That's not the time of the year you really expect those systems to make that long trek across and really survive. A lot of systems we see this time of the year are actually systems that can even become a system over land. A batch of convection or a batch of storminess moves out, takes on tropical characteristics, and then begins to move back in. We've seen that happen a couple of times over the last few years. Even remember Danny last year, that was the way that thing moved along. Here's a quick look at it. Let's first of all concentrate where our hurricanes are right now off the Pacific coast. We have two of note presently to have a look at. This one being Hurricane Lester and this one being Hurricane Madeline. Let's have a look at Hurricane Lester's current position. It's presently 180 miles south of Acapulco, Mexico. Winds 105 miles per hour, moving west at 8,973 millibars. That's its current pressure. As we look on to where the problems could be, number of spots here, especially from Acapulco southward towards Salina Cruz, that red shading right there indicates where we have hurricane warnings, meaning as long as this thing is close to the coast, we could endure hurricane force conditions with some incredible wind here. The primary threat from this hurricane, in case you have coastal interest here or you are here in this region, is going to be the heavy-duty rains. As a result of its proximity to land, we could honestly see maybe some 5 to 10-inch amounts of rain. Could be a little higher where the orographic effect kicks in. You have some high mountainous terrain. That works as far as kind of helping to accentuate some of the moisture. That could be a problem here. It is expected to continue its westward motion. In case, by chance, it should take more of a northward jog, that would be very bad. Don't want to see that happen too much the way of coastline here. It could cause more mudslide problems. As this thing moves west, it should continue that for a while. But beyond about 36 hours, take more of a west-northwesterly track. Don't expect much of a change in strength, maybe just a little. That would be about it. Further north of here, Hurricane Madeline with 85-mile-per-hour sustained winds. System right there should continue on toward the north. Don't expect much in the way of any type of changes with strength. It could, though, dump 10 to 15 inches of rain in some areas. This one has been a big rain producer, again, because of its proximity here to a number of areas. We could deal with a lot of heavy-duty rain, even the storm surge up a bit, 2 to 4 feet above your average astronomical tides there. Beyond about 48 hours, this thing should begin to take more of a north-northeasterly trek, and some of that moisture may be drug in and deposited across the U.S. as far as bringing some more rain potential to us. It could happen. Looking at this area right now, but again, upper-level conditions not really in favor of something happening, but monitoring a batch of convection nonetheless. We talk about the westerlies, we talk about shear, how that works to limit development. Bit of a tropical wave trying to make its way westward. I make a little bit of a move that way. You can see it moving, but it's being hindered by the shear or the ripple off. You can see some of the higher wispy clouds being blown back on toward the east. I mentioned the Cape Verde region a little while ago. Not much happening here. Not climatologically the favored time for a pre-existing spin to move along and make its long trek across the Atlantic. Have a look now toward the Pacific. What at one point was Typhoon Zeb is now way out of the picture. Dumped a lot of rain, though, into portions of the Philippines and on toward Japan. Now, though, Tropical Storm Babs, it's making a slow westward drift, and the wind shear is lessening just a bit. Actually, it's just been upped a bit. The strength of it itself now around about 75 miles per hour. Again, so just in moments ago now, it's no longer Tropical Storm Babs, but Typhoon Babs. Slow westward drift is bad. It means that the Philippines could have an impact from this. The wind shear is going to be lessening, as I mentioned. In other words, the inhibiting factor will be lessening, giving even a greater chance to intensify. Typhoon Babs, as of a few moments ago. We'll keep you on top of that here at the Weather Channel. Across the contiguous 48, some showers along our front, but the heaviest rains have been into Texas, evidenced by these right here, including San Antonio totals over 14 inches. Wow. Flash flood potential pretty great in the parts of Texas. They see just a lingering chance of a strong storm. Unfortunately, it's still wet. That's a look at the Storm Watch being sponsored by the Home Depot. We've got Weather Center next.
Coming up next, rain stretching from the Gulf Coast to the Northeast is on the move. We'll show you where it's headed on Weather Center after your local forecast.
If you spend any time in the cold, you should know Wohl's has clothes to keep you warm. We've been keeping active folks comfortable for over 50 years with clothes for winter's worst. Because we know the weather won't give you a break. Unless you take one. Wohl's, leading the way outdoors.
Wohl's quality outerwear is available.
Totaling up.